How's everyone today? I'm just gonna start this out and see where we go. Started playing Lone Oak, and of course, I fell in love with it as usual. That's what happens when you play Bullet Bill's maps, you fall in love with them. So I'm doing this one a little different. I'm gonna do large machinery for the most part. Got my farm pretty much set up. There's a shop in here where you can customize your vehicles. Of course, everybody's seen this. My two larger John Deere tractors with their seeders. I have another John Deere tractor that's out in the field plowing right now. Here. I'm just going to plow these, hopefully both of those fields without too much trouble. And I'm going to start cultivating. I've got all the fields that I own manured. And I have quite a few fields, actually. If you have a look here, I'll show you what I own. So everything in blue are fields that I own. These two fields here, this field in 45, 44, all these fields are grass, plus 42. And my plan is to produce cattle and sheep off the bat, and eventually work into some pigs as well. Everything that's dark blue has been manured and either plowed or cultivated. I haven't plowed much. Maybe next time we will. So I'm going to plant probably potatoes in 32. And the rest of the fields are going to be cereal crops. I'm not going to bother with any anything other than cereal crops. Potatoes, I'm not going to use sugar beets. They'd probably be easier because I don't have to have a separate planter or anything. But I'm going to go with potatoes because I like doing potatoes. That's field 45 off to my left here. That's been planted in grass for this year anyways. I'll probably do something else with it next year. I think I'm going to have lots of grass fields, so I'll probably be rotating them out to crops after the first year and turn some of them into grass fields after a couple of years of crops. I'll just rotate through, hoping to earn enough money to be able to purchase some more fields, although I've pretty much got an unlimited supply here right now. I haven't purchased the harvester yet, although I did get some hay equipment, because I hopefully will be able to get some hay off the fields and maybe some silage bales off a couple of fields in mid-spring. Right now I'm waiting for mid-spring, probably before I'm going to be planting, because it doesn't look like I'm going to get soil temperatures that are high enough to even plant anything right now, other than grass, that is. So this is my old John Deere 8970. I've been cultivating most of my fields with this one. Works pretty good with the cultivator. The 8030 is the plow tractor. I have my other two tractors up there waiting for the weather, the warmer weather. I'm thinking I'm probably going to have to buy another 8030. If for haying season. And I might just sell this tractor off after the first crop year. Although it's nice and I like it. We'll get the two bigger tractors, more power. Bigger horsepower engines. I think they're both around 620, 670. Whereas this one's around 400. And I might just buy a smaller trailer or smaller tractor to run the baler. We'll see what happens as we go. It's been a bit since I've streamed. Doing fairly good on my drop frame rates today, so hopefully you'll be able to get this in at least 480p. I think both of my shaders are planted through anyways, but where I've been working fields, I'm gonna have to cultivate them in to get the flower or the fertilizer credit, which is what I've been doing. So I'm playing 12-day seasons, and I've got the time set to 5 times, which kind of makes sense with the amount of land I have right now. I can get pretty much everything done, I think, without rushing too much, especially since I can't plant yet. Everything's still a little bit slow. Today's probably the last day this week until maybe Sunday that I could actually do a stream. It is the 12th, I believe, of July today. So if you're watching this later, I don't know the date when I'm doing this. 2018, I'll probably say in the description what date it is, I'm not sure. Turn that down. Keep our sound go down a little on the mic so you're not getting up any background noises. good tractor. It'll pull this harrow. Doesn't seem to matter what the terrain angles are. At 20 kilometers an hour, which is the maximum speed of the harrow, the working speed. Thinking if I have time, I'm gonna actually start cutting some wood and harvest in a bit just to make things a little more interesting. There seems to be lots of trees on the map. And that's an easy way to make some money in this game, harvesting trees. That's fine. It's Thursday morning, so I imagine most people are probably still at work or sleeping. Depending on where in the world they are. Release date for the Walker's Farm map, which I'm waiting for because I really want to play that one. I'm assuming it's going to be excellent. Everything they've done looked like it. I've seen some video on it. Saw that it should be releasing within the next week. I hope. Definitely going to be a big map for big tools, big equipment. It should be a fun one to play. We're having some fun anyways. I haven't been playing much. I kind of got back into it. I did some multiplayer stuff this week. One day, multiplayer anyways, with Delta. I intend to try and get back in with that if I can. As much as I can. Not always awake when he's streaming. No. Although there's only a 1 hour time zone difference, there should be a round available, but sometimes, you know, I have other things on the go. He's still plowing away. I'm guessing he's probably halfway into the second field by now. He probably will go into that third field, which is straight ahead of me. And he's done that. But I could be wrong. To watch him. He's into the second field now. I don't want him to do 34 or 42. So I'll have to actually go in and stop him before before he gets into field 42. That's one of my big grass fields. I intend to leave it as grass, probably permanently. There's too many trees and depressions and stuff in that field for it to be much fun trying to cultivate and harvest fields. Yeah. Second, and... on there. That out. I'll only be streaming probably another 15 minutes or so this morning. I'll try and finish this field. See how that goes. I'll try a GPS. See how that works for this. So that means I have to go that. Let's see where that takes us. There we go. I downloaded a GPS program for my GrowCat. Apparently doesn't work as well as I hoped it would. Of course, I did try and screw around with it, so I might have made the mistake of screwing that up and saving it back to it. We'll see. My guess is that I did. Fairly large fields. It takes some good harvesting. I'm looking forward to it. isn't the way I was always taught to harrow. And usually I never used anything this big, of course. But, we always had to drag harrows. Just have to get out and pull a lever forward to lift the discs or the spring teeth. So basically you didn't... you did the whole field. You didn't lift it in between or anything like that. More or less did loops. Kind of like what I'm doing here. Fields down with the broadcast spreader. You do pass with fertilizer cultivated in, and then you do pass with the seed, barley or oats or whatever it was that we were doing that day. Light harrowing over it just to set it in with the spring tooth. Just like down so it's just barely touching the ground, maybe down 5 or 6 mils. That would set the seed in. Also scare away the birds that were eating the seed. Hold it for a little bit so that some of it would grow instead of, you know, the birds just getting fat and nothing growing. Wasn't exactly scientific, you know. But it worked. All open air cabs as well, which was kind of nice. Sun shining down on your head, warmth, a bit of a breeze from the tractor. No GPS, you always did it by eye. Check on my plow tractor there, see how he's doing. I think I'll probably wait another couple minutes and I'll stop him before he gets into the grass field. And I'll finish that myself. So I think what I'll do is set you to work. Jump over here. Finish this myself. tractor. Works pretty well. Take that GPS and turn it off though. Need it on for this. It also has reverse drive. Which is one of the reasons why I wanted this tractor. Because I will be putting mowers on it. When we get this mid-spring off the mower, start with some silage bales, and some hay bales. If I do it that way, I can put the three mowers that I bought, the Pottinger mowers, and they all hook together so you can put them on. So I'll reverse drive the Pottinger mowers. And on the other end, I'll put, I have a merger, which I bought. I'll show you all that for sure. I bought the Coon merger, so I'll be able to run that. Has completed their task. That means my field is half done. I have to move the big E970 up. This is actually an 8530. It's an 8030 model with a bigger engine. Basically, it's a fully loaded tractor. Excuse me. As soon as I hit this, I'm gonna run over and put this away. I'll show you my set some of it up, and I will end my stream there, I expect. I like this garage that Billy Bill put in. It's nice and big, lots of room to maneuver. My weeder. Got my potato seeder. Row crop seeder. Surreal seeder. Sit next to each other, all hooked up and ready to go. I think I'm done with the plow to the fall. I'm gonna put it right back in here in the back corner. Out of the way. Thank you. it back up. The merger and the rhino rake. We'll use the merger for my silage bales. This is my silage setup. And when I want to do hay bales, I'll put the rhino rake on there, which tethers it at the same time. And I've got this, which I can hook up and set up, and hopefully it'll work together. End the stream there, everyone. Thanks for watching. I know it's going to be later, you're going to watch it.